Back home, One News has obtained figures showing more children are being placed in state care compared to a year ago. It goes against the advice put forward by the Royal Commission of Inquiry into Abuse and has survivors worried, warning the government it needs to act now. Ryan Boswell reports.
Ever since this baby was born, it's being monitored by the state.
I'm fighting for my kids. Why can't they see that?
The child's sibling was killed by their father, who was sent to jail, convicted of manslaughter. The mother stands by him, saying it was an accident, but she's worried her baby will end up in Oranga Tamariki care.
I consider the fact what happened, but I'm looking forward to their life when they're going to be teenage. I don't want to end up my kids to be a drug addict.
She's being supported by abuse survivor Gwyneth Beard, who's trying to keep children out of state care.
Our system is just a total mess. It's designed to disempower and destroy whānau.
The Royal Commission found there is no future for Oranga Tamariki. It recommended the state hand over power, funding and control to care services at a local level.
All too often, care is lacking, and we need a fundamental re-envisioning of care in our country.
In the financial year ending mid-2019, there were close to 2,000 entries into state care. The number of children being uplifted subsequently fell, but in the last financial year, there was a 20% increase. Oranga Tamariki says earlier intervention and working with whānau and the wider community has resulted in an overall reduction.
If we need to uplift because they're unsafe, we will do it. But when we do uplift, my expectation is that they are safe.
Just as the Pike River tragedy led to WorkSafe, the Royal Commission says the pervasive abuse it's uncovered must lead to a new care safe agency.
I don't like our young people being in care and protection, but what I would also say to you is we can't close down something without a solution.
Oranga Tamariki adamant that for now, some children are only safe if they're removed from the home they're in. Ryan Boswell, One News.
The Royal Commission's final report calls for urgent action on the issue of unmarked graves at former institutions. Preliminary works found a large number at or near places where abuse and care occurred. This includes likely 1,000 in Christchurch public cemeteries associated with Sunnyside Psychiatric Hospital, over 2,000 at Porirua Cemetery and 500 at Tokanui in Waikato due to facilities nearby. In Martin, near Lake Alice, near Dunedin and Waikumete in Auckland, there are also numerous unmarked graves. It's believed many of these may be from before the inquiry period, that's pre-1950, and adults. An investigation's been recommended that could lead to whānau being connected. Political editor Mikey Sherman has more.
This cemetery is one of many across Christchurch where officials believe there are likely 1,000 unmarked graves belonging to former psychiatric patients.
We as a nation, I feel we have got a very dark past.
At age 13, Terry Kingy was in a psychiatric hospital in Nelson, where he says electric shock treatment saw him lose all of his teeth, while other children, he says, simply vanished.
There was two other young Maori boys in my ward, and when I came back one day, they had disappeared. And I know the police a number of years ago did an investigation to find where they are. They virtually have disappeared off the face of the earth. Nobody knows where they went.
The Abuse and Care Report recommends ACC provide compensation for survivors within the next 2 years.
We need to step through this process carefully. We need to understand who we are helping, what sort of help we provide them, what sort of redress.
Are they just hoping that most of us will die off like myself? I'm 72. I don't have long on this planet now, let's face it.
The inquiry also calls for police to investigate those responsible for committing torture.
The people who committed these crimes, they knew what they were doing, and so if you have an investigation, clears that out, and that validates the survivors again.
Recommendations include sweeping policy changes, giving effect to Te Tiriti o Waitangi and partnering with Māori, something critics argue is the polar opposite to some government policies, like repealing Section 7AA of the Oranga Tamariki Act and youth military boot camps.
We're doing a powerful targeted intervention in the life of serious young offenders because we do not want them going down a pathway into bigger crime and into gang life in particular.
We can't have a Prime Minister say we see you, we hear you, and then start to support boot camps, support the removal of 7AA.
As for survivors, they're waiting for compensation.
Yeah, I mean, if we've got $2.9 billion for the landlords, then we can have the same for the survivors.
A call to the government to get on with it. Mikey Sherman, One News.